I'm really thankful to the United Nations ex-Secretary General, Mr. Ban Ki-moon, and his whole team of Globe Green Initiative Institute for having invited us to South Korea. India is a signatory to the Smart Green Cities concept. And I wish to put on record, my Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, has done immensely for empowering the green and the smart cities concept. When under his own government schemes which were introduced on 25th June 2015, 100 new smart green cities schemes were announced in Republic of India. Under those schemes, 100 crore of rupees for each smart green cities was sanctioned in Republic of India, and a matching grant by the respective states were also announced, under which the pollution was to be controlled, the housing projects which bring about a radical change in agriculture, projects which bring about a radical change and which decrease the pollution levels, which bring out amicable distribution of drinking water, and which also bring the polluting effect in our environment for sustainable growth of the mankind have been undertaken by the Prime Minister, Mr. Modi's government in India. And today I can say with great satisfaction, the Prime Minister's own constituency, Varanasi, located in the most populous state of Uttar Pradesh, I wish to share this with all the global delegates who have gathered from all over the world at this World Environment Meet, which has been convened in South Korea, in Seoul, that Varanasi today is one of those cities which has turned out to be one of the most green cities, smart cities in Republic of India. With the renewable energy measures undertaken, with clean water conservation facilities undertaken, with amicable, fair, balanced distribution of water facilities undertaken, with transport facilities whereby clean and green fuel facilities undertaken, the government of India, led by its able Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi, has shown the world with a clear determination, with a political determination, though there might have been paucity of funds, but no amount of determination could stop his initiative to bring about a change in the life and style of the poor people in his own constituency. So I reiterate the commitment for a green environment, a strong pollution-free environment to the world powers be on behalf of the government of India. And I also wish to reiterate that the Indian People's Party, the Bharatiya Janata Party, led by its able president, Mr. Amit Shah, commanding 110 million political workers in India, is the largest political party in the world. And like my chairman, Mr. George D. Venecia, the former chairman of the Philippines Parliament, who has stated, the political parties have a strong role to play in the world's sustainable green cities concept. And I can certainly say the workers of the Indian People's Party, the Bharatiya Janata Party, are committed for a global green concept and a revolution, not only in India, but to stand shoulder to shoulder with all the parties, with all the nations in Asia, in Africa, in Europe. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.